Like I said at Money's Car Stereo, can't stop, won't stop. Man, we got Michael Mashak over here again. I be trying to tell him go home, but he just keep coming over here. I don't know. Because I put him to work on his own shit sometimes.
Yeah, that's why.
If you're in the inner circle, I'm going to let you come over here and wrench on yourself. Unless you're just really lazy, don't want to give me some money. But if you want to know what's going on with your stuff,
and you
in my circle, you can. I'll let you do it yourself. I'll coach you through it. We'll work it out. Anyway, back to what I was saying. We got my man. Last night, we turned him on with one bag only. Today, we fine-tuned him. So, you know, like I said, it's just you and I together. As we like to say over here at Money's Car Stereo, on to the next one. We out. Next! Here we are, live and direct over at Money's Car Stereo. You know, I know some people who know some people. Man, who am I talking to today, man?
It's E, man. E from Oakland.
E from Oakland?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man. Sal called me and said, man, you know a brother named E from the town? I said, well, I know a lot of people. He said he know you. I said, I don't know what we're going to see. Maybe we know each other, our paths will cross again. Hey, he here at my spot
right now.
Man, I see you got this patch on your vest, man.
Which one?
This one up here, man. What that? Tell me what that be about, man.
Oh, this one right here?
Yeah, with the little red on it and stuff, with the white. What the red stand for?
This the one that separates the real from the fake, man.
What?
This the one that separates them cats that just like to ride up and down the street to them cats that like to ride up and down the highway.
Oh, yes, okay. So you saying the white is you written in or the red you written in? Which one is it?
The white is soon to be completed.
Oh, okay. So you ain't conquered that part yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
That red, you know, most of this was missing the last time you seen me.
Yeah. You was a little bit checkerboarded when I saw you last time. I didn't realize what was going on until I recently was informed that you was in Sturgis.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So how was that ride?
Uh-huh. It was an experience that you got to do at least one time, man.
Okay.
I mean, it was beautiful, the landscape, all the shit. And a lot of times individuals get to talking that, oh, man, I don't want to go up there. These white folks. I'm going to tell you something. I really didn't experience no racism. Now, mind you, you know, you get a look or two from these individuals that's like, what the hell is all of these black folks doing on these horses? In the Sturgis about 20-30 deep.
Not 20-30 deep? Y'all made a strong stand like, yeah, we, fuck with one, you fuck with all.
We definitely did, man.
Okay.
I was out there with my boy Sil and a few of my partners from Southern California.
Okay, so the route you went down and grabbed some brothers from down south and went on with you?
What ended up happening is I really was going with about 12 people.
Uh-huh.
And when it was all said and done,
they backed out.
I was on the highway by myself.
God damn.
But I will say this, and I have to say thank you to Big Man and Nook from Bonafide Riders, because they decided to ride me on into, they decided to escort me into Nevada and end up pushing all the way to the Utah state line with me, which was a plus, you know what I mean?
Okay.
On the highway with some good cats.
Yeah.
They turned around after they got their state lines and I did it moving on into Utah.
Yeah, because Big Man, he called me when he saw me over in New York. He said, Rob, every time I try to go up there, something happened. And I got to go this way. I go, I can't never make that, but I see you done got it.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, man, I got that in Long Island, baby.
Yeah. So 9 times out of 10, when I get ready to hit that East Coast, man, me and Manny going to try to get it in because we both got that left.
Okay.
Yeah. I had a couple good dudes, man. They came from Southern California, a couple of youngsters.
Yeah.
I picked them up in Salt Lake City. We waited on one of our boys in Wyoming. He had some bike trouble
for about
6 hours.
Yeah. Okay. So how was it out there? I see you on your 107. What year are we talking about here? What is this here?
This is 18.
18?
18. Special.
Was there any issues on the freeway? Pretty much trouble free. Any you know, road shit happens sometimes. Anything? It didn't let you down?
For the most, I mean, you know, my bike I stand the test of time, man, because I make sure that I service mine.
Ah, service is the key.
All the time.
Okay, okay. All the time. You were telling me you had a one of something on here that you only can get there, like, you know, like when you get these special t-shirts and whatnot, you say you can only get.
This right here? Make sure you get a good shot of that.
That says Black Hills 2020.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So that means that if you wasn't there, you can't get that.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
That part right there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Hey, you know, he said he was out there. I was out there at the same time. We came a week earlier, but, you know, we was hitting and moving and grabbing lines and miles and patches and chips from stores and keeping it moving, you know, just to let you know we was here. And, you know, but my man said, well, I will say this, rewind conversation. I said to myself, when Sal go out there and come back and give a report of what he encountered, it gonna let y'all know it's safe to travel.
Oh, without a doubt, man. I mean, honestly, we had a ball, bro. Uh-huh. We had two big-ass houses, all the food you could eat, all the alcohol they could drink, because I don't drink.
Uh-huh.
And everything they wanted, man, the garage was like a damn dealership.
That nice, huh? Okay, so if you had to tell anybody any key things about this ground pounding, what would you say? I got my statement I've come up with, but what would you say?
Well, ultimately, first things first is you got to make sure your bike is right.
Yeah.
Make sure that you service your bike, maintain your bike, you know, everything. Make sure that it's going to stand the test of time. Because once you get out there, you don't want to be in the middle of nowhere and you hit.
Mm-hmm.
Keep that AAA.
Okay, okay. Premier?
I caught a flat in Idaho, man. Stayed a day, and I got a trip interruption coming. So they paying for hotel, food, all that
what?
Good shit.
What? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
AAA Premier, y'all hear that?
You gotta have it.
So was the Harley deck helpful on navigation-wise and whatnot?
I really didn't even use it. I'm gonna tell you what I use. I use a map, bro.
Yeah, old school paper map.
Listen, bro. I use a map, man.
Okay, okay.
I read that map like it's the Bible. I need to know that map through and through so I'm knowing where I'm going. And if for some reason these, because there's times where you're going to be using this phone and you ain't going to have no satellite.
Uh-huh.
You know, I'm listening to my radio.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, all of a sudden, I can't hear nothing.
Uh-huh.
What's going on? So you got to have.
Hold on a second. See if it's the only time we're back. Go.
The map.
The map.
Uh-huh. Bottom line. North and south, east and west.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta know what the 10 is at the bottom, then the 20, the 30, the 40, 70, 80, all the way up. You need to know these things, man, because this shit ain't gonna do you no good.
You get the blind spot and it's nowhere.
You know what
okay,
I mean?
Okay.
You got to know that, man, look, I keep going. I haven't hit Cheyenne yet, so once I hit Cheyenne, then I can go up north and take this highway 85, and that's gonna take me to South Dakota. You got to know these things, man. You know, you rely on this technology, bro. You gonna be hit. That old school shit ain't never
ain't let you down.
Never.
Yeah. Okay.
Ever.
Okay.
Keep it AAA. You can go to AAA anytime you want. Get you a map of any region.
Okay.
Anytime you want, man.
That AAA, y'all. He promoting that AAA, which I'm a believer of that too, y'all.
I'm just saying shit.
So. How was that Yellowstone? You said you went through Yellowstone. Because I went through Yellowstone also. We came in through the south and the east. You said you came in from the...
I came from Idaho.
From the north and exited out the west.
I came from Montana.
Oh, Montana.
And came down to Yellowstone. Beautiful, bro. When you come in... And basically, I came from north to south. You push it through there. You look to the right. You see all the water. You see them white rafting and fly fishing and... My only problem was I couldn't stop because I was trying to beat the daylight on this two-lane road, right?
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah.
I got fucking bison crossing, so I'm like, look, bro, we got to get it.
Yeah, yeah.
The last thing I want to be is on the side of this road, on this road, and they got bison crossing.
At nighttime, it's no good, yeah.
And you hit the throttle and you scare them, and next thing you know, you got a 1,000-pound beast chasing you.
Nah, you don't want that. Nah, you don't want that, yeah.
I don't want that.
Just idle through them. Okay, I'm going to get on. I've seen some video where they're taking out a few tourists getting too close. Yeah.
I encourage anybody who don't really, you got a lot of cats out here talking about the ride. I mean, to each his own.
Yeah.
I know I get on this highway and I get it in, man. And I love it because I meet different people from everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Every state, you see something different. You see how they do. Once you get out of your little pocket, man, you experience so much different stuff, bro. I mean, shit, you just got off of what, a 31 states?
Yeah, 31 states.
I wish I would have knew. I told Silk, God damn it, I wish I would have knew, man. I would have knocked it down with you. However, we got Atlanta Roundup next year.
Yeah.
All these cats talking about the trailing, they this, they that. Lock it in, man. We going on the ground.
Get your vacation days up, y'all.
Yeah.
Get your maintenance right, get your money right, and get your time right.
You got a whole year, man.
We going to hit it on the ground going that way. We may take the long way to get there.
Why not?
Yeah. If you got the time, why not? We're going to run 80 up top and run it across.
Matter of fact, Sale them talking about doing the four corners around that time and ended up in
the roundup.
In Florida and come right back to Georgia. So that might be the ticket.
Yeah. We're gonna have to synchronize this and we're going to figure out how we're going to get in. And I suggest y'all come get some yonder with us because it ain't about the speed no more. We about how much experience of the world you can get in your life, you know.
You want to race me? Let's race to Florida and back.
All right.
Let's race to New York and back.
Hey, my new thing I'm telling Cass is, man, I'm going to ride with you to run out of freeway or land. Which one you want first? I know where it's at. I've been there.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. My own thing I tell people is ride, rest, and repeat. Ride, rest, and repeat.
You got to get your rest.
Got to get your rest.
Yeah. Otherwise, you're going to be sleeping on that highway. Next thing you know, you're going to be on the side of the highway.
Yeah.
So you got to get your rest, man. It's important. Get your rest.
And stay hydrated, too.
And make sure you service that bike, man.
Oh, yeah.
You got to. You take care of your bike gonna take care of you. I promise you.
Y'all heard it. Yeah. All right, Money's Car Stereo. I'm just letting you see what I see. I know some people. Gotta go.
Well, I noticed something. When you're out there on these roads and you're stopping at your Harley-Davidson dealerships, which are conveniently located right off the freeway, most of the time, you're looking for two things, or three things. A part for your bike, a t-shirt to show where you've been. Well, they got this little thing that you can buy from Harley-Davidson to show where you've been that don't really cost a whole bunch. But it lets you know, hey, I was there. On our last trip of 33 states, I managed to stop at a few Harley-Davidsons. We got, let's see, Buffalo Bill in Cody, Wyoming. You got Trips Harley-Davidson, Amarillo, Texas. You got Jackson Hole Harley-Davidson. That's over in Jackson, Wyoming. The Grand Canyon Harley-Davidson. In Arizona. Let me see what else we got here. Thunder Tower. And outside in Marietta, Georgia. Bam. Morrow, Georgia, that is. And yeah, black owned Harley-Davidson. Middletown, Virginia. Harley-Davidson. Natchez Trace in Harley-Davidson. I don't know what state that is. What state was that in? Alabama. We got Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Harley-Davidson. Gave good service over there. Bought a few t-shirts. Got another one in Richmond, Virginia, Harley-Davidson. We got Oklahoma City, Harley-Davidson. We got Livermore, that was the last one on the way in. Kemen, Arizona, Harley-Davidson. We got Marietta, Atlanta, Georgia. That'll be Hellborn. My man works over there, Juan. Yeah. So we got a little collection here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 of them. And they sell little cases you can put them in. But we're going to see what we do with them. Gotta go.
Once again, live and direct, we got Michael Mayshak.
What's going on, y'all?
What's going on, Mike? You came by today. This is my riding partner. You know, from the around the world in 13 days,
something like that.
You know,
it took you 15, but we ain't gonna win.
I did it in 13. He did it in 12.
There we go.
Oh, he may say 11 and a half. I don't know. I wasn't here when he touched down. So, but anyway.
Anyway, Rob, I got something in the mail.
Uh-huh.
Something I bought for you.
What? For me?
For you, brother.
Oh, man.
Commemorate your ride. While you got the phone, I'm going to go ahead and open it.
Okay.
I saw it, and I thought about you. While on our ride, we was collecting chips.
Right,
right. You see what it says?
Respect is earned. Loyalty is returned.
I had this made.
Oh, man.
Handmade.
Oh.
Brother.
Okay.
And it's for you.
I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Oh, man. Okay. This is something going to go. Man, we've talked about them chips that I acquired earlier, and you can only get those chips if you go there. You can't order them. T-shirts you can probably order, but chips you can't get there. It's a physical thing. You know, they're not expensive, but it's just a little something that say, hey, I was there. How many you get, Mike?
I got 13.
Okay. I got about maybe one extra because I did maybe one or two extra, but, you know, the goal is to fill up the board, you know, and let people see what you see. That's what I'm going to do with mine.
There you go.
You best do something with y'all's. Hey, got to go, Money's Car Stereo. Just letting y'all see what I see. Remember, respect is earned. Loyalty is returned. You know it.